To this session, I am Priyanka Bidla, and today we are going to discuss about block diagram fundamentals and reduction rules. These are the learning outcomes of this video lecture. At the end of this session, students will be able to represent the block diagram with transfer function, and second outcome will be to apply the rules for reducing the block diagram. These are the contents of this video lecture. Basically, block diagram is a pictorial representation of the cause and effect relationship between input and output of a system. It's very difficult to analyze the entire system as it is without breaking into small parts. So, to analyze such system, block diagrams are used. This is the simplest form of block diagram. Here, it is a single block with one input that is X and the one output that is Y. A mathematical operation performed by that system and output is produced according to the input. The arrow indicates the direction of flow of signal from one block to another block. Now recall what is the transfer function of system. Now pause the video for a while and you have to recall the transfer function of a system. Transfer function. The system parameters are designed and their values are selected as per the requirement of input. Therefore, the performance of system parameters are expressed in terms of their output. So we can write down system parameters are nothing but that is a gain. So gain is equal to output upon input or Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input. So we can write down output is equal to gain into input. So gain is nothing but performance of the system parameters. Then we consider here the components of block diagram. There are the four basic components. So we see one by one. The first is the signals. So here this is the R of S and this is a C of S. R of S is nothing but reference signal and C of S is the controlled signal. So R of S is the reference input that is a Laplace transform of the R of T. And C of S is the controlled output. This is the Laplace transform of C of T. Second component, transfer function of components shown inside the block diagram. Here G of S is nothing but transfer function of system. Input is nothing but R of S. And this is the output is nothing but C of S. So this is the representation of system. Then summing point. Here this is summing point. One or more than one elements can added or subtracted at the summing point. Here R1 of S and R2 of S are added directly. So here we get C of S is equal to R1 of S plus R2 of S. Suppose here the sign is negative, then we can write here R1 of S minus R2 of S. By default, if there is no sign, then it will be considered as a plus. Then the next fourth component, that is takeoff point. This is a takeoff point, the point from which signal is taken for the feedback purpose. R of S, R of S, R of S. So these signals are taken from this point for the feedback purpose. Then we see the advantages of block diagram. There are the four advantages. So first is a very simple to construct for complicated system. Then second, we can write down the individual elements from the block diagram. Then third, individual as well as the overall performance of the system can be studied using the transfer functions. And then the fourth is you can calculate the closed loop transfer function of a system directly by using the block diagram reduction rules. So there are the total 10 rules. In this video lecture, we will see the first three rules. Then these advantages of block diagram. Block diagram does not involve any information about the system. Then second, energy source is not shown in the block diagram. And third one is nothing but it can be applied only for the linear time invariant systems. Then here we can calculate the simple form of closed loop system. For that, we have to calculate the transfer function. All these signals are Laplace transform of the particular signals. So R of S is nothing but reference signal Laplace of R of T. E of S is the Laplace of error signal, that is E of T. Then B of S is here, we can write minus and plus. It may be minus or it may be negative or it may be positive. The meaning of this is a feedback signal. So feedback may be negative or positive. It is a Laplace transform of B of T. Then G of S is nothing but it's a forward path transfer function. And H of S is the feedback path transfer function. Feedback path means here the path indicates the flow of direction from output to input. So this is feedback path, and the forward means it is from input to output direction. Then C of S is the control output, that is a Laplace transform of C of T. Here G of S and H of S can be obtained by reducing the complicated block diagram. So from that diagram we can write these equations. So E of S is equal to reference signal minus plus B of signal. Then B of S is equal to, it's the product of C of S and H of S. Then C of S is the product of E of S and G of S. From this you can write down E of S is equal to C of S divided by G of S. Then here that is B of S is equal to C of S H of S. So we put the value of equation 2 in the equation 1. So we get E of S is equal to R of S minus plus C of S into H of S. Now compare the equation 4 and 5. Here left hand side E of S and E of S are equal. So right hand side are equal. So we can write down this equation. After solving these equations, we get the transfer function. That is C of S divided by R of S is equal to G of S upon 1 plus or minus G of S into H of S. Transfer function is nothing but output upon input. So C of S divided by R of S, we get this equation. So this is the transfer function of closed loop system. And remember, if there is a plus sign, then this is a negative feedback. If there is negative sign, then this is a positive feedback. Then we see the rules for the block diagram reduction. There are three rules for reduction of the block diagram. So first is what? Any complicated system is brought into the simpler form. First we have to reduce the block diagram. Then second, using proper logic of the system and value of the feedback should not get disturbed. And third, we will now analyze some common topologies for interconnecting subsystem. Some common topologies are used for the reduction of the block diagram. So we see the rules. So rule 1 is associative law. Here this is the cascade connection of the summing parts. Here R1 is given to this first summing point and R2 and R3 are given respectively. So here this is a minus sign, so R1 minus R2, and then this output is given to the next summing point. So we get R1 minus R2 plus R3. This is the final output of this summing points. Now in this figure you have to consider exchange of summing points. So here we have to exchange the summing points. So instead of R2 here R3 is there, and instead of R3 here R2 is there. So here we get R1 plus R3, and then R1 plus R3 is given to second summing point. So here we get R1 plus R3 minus R2. So after exchanging the position of the summing points, then also we get the same output. This is associative law. Second, blocks in series or cascade. The transfer function of the blocks which are connected in series get multiplied with each other. If the blocks are in series, then we can get multiplied directly. If n blocks are there, and the transfer function of respective blocks G1 to Gn, then take the product of these blocks. So it is represented by this equation. Consider example, R of S is given to G1 and here we get R of S into G1. And this is applied to next block, so here we get R of S into G1 into G2. This is the before reduction. After reduction, in this case, G1 and G2 are in series. So directly take a product and we get the output R of S G1, G2. This. Blocks in parallel. If the blocks are in parallel, then directly added these blocks. Consider the sign. If there is negative sign, then we have to consider the negative sign. Now consider an example. Here G1, G2 and G3, these blocks are connected in parallel. So directly added to at this summing point. So we get G1 of S plus minus G2 of S plus minus G3 of S. And the R of S is common to all. So we can multiply with R of S. And how to reduce this block? If the blocks are in parallel, then add it directly. So here this is the equivalent transfer function of the parallel subsystem. Remaining rules we will see in the next video lecture. These are the references. Thank you.